But it's also true that people don't really want to believe what's actually happening in the church. The enemy has overrun the church. Much of the church has already been defeated. Now, people may not want to believe that because they still gather together on Sunday, but the enemy has, for the most part, defeated the church. And Lynn, I was there at the beginning of the invasion. In the late 1970s, the Lord sent me to a Christian youth concert, and it was at the end of a weekend that was one of the most amazing weekends of my life, in which I had an opportunity to basically go into the Holy of Holies, and the Lord spoke audibly to me and three other people, and this entire weekend, we basically were in the presence of the Lord the entire time, and at the end of the weekend, when I returned home, the Lord told me, I want you to go to church tonight to the youth concert. So I went, and when this was right when the Jesus rock music first began to come into the church, and this band began playing this new version of Christian worship. They called it Jesus Rock back in those days. Lynn, as this band started playing, I saw thousands of devils fly up out of the stage and fill the entire church in a canopy of darkness over the heads of the people. And there must have been several thousand demons were now filling this church. And this was a spirit-filled church that had witnessed powerful moves of the Holy Spirit in its history. And here in this youth concert, the auditorium filled with evil spirits, and most of the people were just clapping their hands and, you know, keeping time with their feet and enjoying this ministry in the flesh, utterly unaware that it was actually satanic. And so the false worship came in the late 70s. Right behind it, the false prophetic movement came. And with the false prophets came a host of false doctrines. And then the false anointing came forth, where the Holy Spirit left many congregations. And in its place, what you find today is a kundalini devil. People are coming under an anointing right out of hell. And if you don't believe me, go on YouTube and type in World Revival Satanic Church, and you can see a church that's filled with this kundalini anointing, and it puts people into epileptic seizures. It's completely out of order. It's not the Lord. And so much of the church has been overrun. And so what do we have? You know, the scripture tells us these are the signs that will follow the true believer. In my name, they'll cast out devils. They'll lay their hands on the sick and they shall recover. What do we find in the majority of the overrun churches today? The words of the false prophet. Rock-a-stop-a-stop.